The merchants had been true to their offer. Still, the water closing over her felt like death. Cold and terrifying. I can breathe! This feels so strange. Wish Lump could have been here. There was nothing I could have done. Was there? But there was no time to dwell on her lost friend.
Robin had a dragon to find.
Which way did it go? This one. All right. Another branching tunnel. The walls were closing in.
Down here, I guess.
Far too narrow for winged beasts.
Did I guess wrong?
A dead end.
Oh, I knew it! Wrong tunnel.
No. There must be a way.
Think, Robin, think! Is this the right way? Or maybe here? I just don't know. I wish I could ask Lump.
But there was no Lump there. No annoying little Lump to complain. No charming Lump to ask for advice either. The submerged tunnels flared outwards. A tangled mess of caverns and hollows. Twisting and turning. Bending with almost malicious intent.
To get out of here. Robin. Breathe. I've got to find the dragon. Get back the fireflies. Do this, Robin.
No!
She found herself amidst a great coral bed, shimmering. No matter what. Beautiful, and now... broken. It grows back, right? Focus on that. No matter what. She spoke those words. But deep in her heart, a seed of chilling doubt took root. The color gave way to darkness, endless and all-consuming. It's cold here. Robbed of sight, the pressure of the deep water on her chest, her thoughts had only one way to go, inwards. What am I doing? I let Lump sacrifice herself for me. And for what? I don't even know where the dragon is, or where I am. I'm falling. I'm failing. Eldareva. The village. Lump. All of them. Huh? What? Doesn't matter. I need to find the dragon, no matter what. A cold determination gripped her. Numbing all other thoughts. Press forward.
to the dragon. Get to the dragon. No matter what. There was just the way forward, barred by an indestructible metal door.
No! I need to find the dragon.
Robin could no longer ignore the seed of doubt. It seeped into her heart, as cold as the water she'd come from.
I need to find it. The dragon. No matter what. No matter what.
The Seekin seemed friendly.
Hey, have you seen the dragon? Wait.
A host of them greeted her with curious chatter, warm and welcoming.
Have you seen the dragon? Please. No.
But Robin had no time for this.
Let me through! I need to find the dragon, no matter what.
The words felt hollow and meaningless. Freezing cold blanketed Robin. There was comfort in its numbing embrace. She wished she could stay.
What's happening? Did I do this?
She did this.
Is this my fault?
It was her fault.
They're home. I destroyed it. Thank you.
a sea king, encased in ice. Guilt dogged her every step.
Did you make me do this?
It would not rest. Would not leave her. It would not cease.
Leave me alone!
The creature looked at her as if it could see into her very soul. Under its stare, her fears crystallized like ice. She knew that she would... be eaten.
You'll consume me until there's nothing left. I can't let that happen.
Would Robin embrace her guilt or run from it? Hello, journal. Dear journal. Hi, journal. Today... Hello, stranger. I've been thinking a lot about my dream is to become a writer. Yeah, right. A writer who can't even write. Okay, find something simple to start with. What did I do today? Today I got up. I had breakfast. I tried watching the telly. That's it. I'm going back to bed. Hi, journal. Another day. Each time I wake up, for the tiniest of moments, it isn't true. Then it all comes rushing back. It is true. Looking around my room, everything reminds me of Gran. Her puzzle box gift from last year. The magic tank we made during the holiday. Our yogurt pot robot. These paints Gran gave me. This pen. Even you, journal. She's everywhere. And all of it feels broken. Today is Ben's birthday. Dad baked a cake. Mum insisted that I come down and have some. tasted like nothing. Everything does. Mum said we need to send out invitations to the funeral. How can she think about that? She's ready to shove Gran into a box like a pet goldfish. Then I stormed off into my room. Later, Dad came up for some well-meant dad talk. I know you're sad, but it will get better. You'll see. Just give it time. I know he wanted to cheer me up, but he's wrong. The world feels very dark now. Gran has a proverb for times like these. Gran always says,
"It's always darkest before the dawn."
No, that's not right. That's what she would have said. I keep thinking about all the things Gran won't get to see. When I go to university, she won't be there. When I get my first job, she won't be there.
if I get married, she won't be there. Even if that's unlikely because... boys. I prefer cats. Missing Gran already feels so bad. But how could I want that feeling to go away? How could I be fine with Gran being gone? I'm going to have to feel like this forever. Thanks, Pinky. I can't stop crying. Pinky is probably getting fed up with being used as a tissue. But she never leaves my side. I think that means get back to writing your story. Pinky's got a point. I should at least try to write. I can't leave Robin like that. She's as lost as I am. My head. Where am I? A grey void surrounded her, swallowing sound and hope. Hello? Robin guessed that if she kept moving, then surely a solution would present itself. Anyone? In the emptiness around her, she found... a hut? A palace? Hope? I don't know what comes next. It's so cold here. So empty. Just... nothingness. I can't find the words. I'm never going to find the dragon. Or the fireflies. They won't come. The words just won't come anymore. I don't know where I am, how to get out, or even where I'm going. Pointless. What kind of writer can't find the words? Let's try this again. Robin awoke under an old tree in an unfamiliar land. I don't know if I can do this anymore.
She walked boldly ahead, a spring in her step.
I'm so tired.
Robin knew she just had to keep going.
What's the point? Put one foot in front of the other. I've failed. It's over.
Whilst she still had breath left in her body, there was still hope.
This is all my fault. I should just stop.
Hey, Robin.
Leave me. Just leave me.
Psst.
Here.
Where? I don't see a thing.
I'm right here. Always was, always will be.
I don't understand. And I don't care.
You don't?
No. Just leave.
I'm meant to be alone. Forever alone and useless.
You know I'm right below you.
I'm not good company right now.
You don't need to be. Why don't you tell me how you came to be here?
It sounds silly when I say it now. I lost a dragon. And now... It's all gone terribly wrong.
What were you trying to do before you got here?
I was trying to find a dragon. It destroyed everything I loved. I need to get the fireflies back. They'll restore my village. But I just don't know what I'm doing anymore.
What did you do last time?
Last time I what?
Found a dragon.
What? I've never found one before.
Then how can you expect to know exactly what to do?
I guess I can't. But I want to.
No one ever got anything just by wanting it. You've got to try. You've got to fail sometimes.
But I don't want to.
I like listening to you. Would you continue?
You do? Oh. Well, okay. It's just...
Completely messed everything up. I just don't know what to do next.
But at some point you knew, right? You had purpose, hope.
Yes. I knew exactly what I needed to do. I had to stop the dragon. Return the fireflies. Save the village.
And you couldn't do those things?
I tried. But I just ended up doing everything wrong.
Everything? Are you sure about that?
Well,
think back.
Okay. Maybe not everything.
Go on.
I managed not to get squashed by a flaming giantess.
Well then, that's something. Go on.
It's difficult.
I'll wait.
I feel so wrung out, so exhausted. Can you help me find the strength to carry on? I'm tired. Tired of trying. Tired of failing. Tired of everything.
You need a rest.
But I can't! I don't have time!
Why?
My village is depending on me to get the fireflies back.
That sounds like quite a tiring thing to do.
Well, yes.
Want to take a rest together?
That sounds nice. I want to know one more thing.
You sound a lot better.
I do? I guess I feel better.
Well then, time to set course.
It's nice of you to listen to me.
Anytime. So, anything else?
To go.
Yes, that is quite the conundrum.
That's not entirely helpful.
You seem to think that it's wrong to be lost.
Well, isn't it?
Everyone feels a little lost sometimes, even me.
Oh. I'd have never imagined you being lost.
I don't mind it, actually. Do you?
Well, yes. I usually know what to do and where to go.
So, if someone else were lost, what would you tell them to do?
I'd tell them to not worry so much. Just continue on until a solution appears.
How about taking your own advice?
Okay, that makes sense. If I had a landmark, I could orientate myself by it.
Let me see if I can help you out there. Patience. This is where I leave.
But I...
You're not alone. You are loved. Be kind to yourself.
Can I do this?
Yes. Be your own light in the darkness.
I'll try. Thank you. Hello, Journal. The funeral was today. Mum and Dad dressed all in black. They even bought a black romper for Ben. I didn't want to wear black. Gran thought black was depressing. That life was dark enough already. Gran always used to say,
colors are the music of nature.
I'm starting to see what she meant. So I went to open my wardrobe. There it was. I hadn't worn it for years. I remember Gran saying it was cheery. The funeral was outside. In the memorial garden. The sun was shining. The birds were singing. It was like they didn't know. The vicar had just started talking when Uncle Alan stepped into the fish pond. I couldn't help but imagine. Gran caring more about the fish than Uncle Alan. The picture stuck in my head. Gran running to the drenched Uncle Alan, grumbling at him for frightening the fish. It was too much. The laughter bubbled up inside me. Dad tried to look annoyed. After the vicar finally finished droning on, we started the singing. All things bright and beautiful. Bull! Ben started wailing. No, howling. Dad took him out. Well played, Ben. Laughing felt much better than crying. The wake was at our place. There were so many people. I didn't know most of them.
Everyone said how sorry they were.
How Gran was. Such a wonderful lady. I wish she could have heard them. Everyone had a story about Gran. Like the time she hit a bully with her pencil box. Or when she saved a toad that had hurt its leg. How she decorated Mum's room like an underwater kingdom, so she could feel like a mermaid. That's so like her. One old lady told me how they used to bunk off work and go to the Glastonbury Music Festival. Another of her friends said Gran once got arrested. While protesting whaling. I expected this day to be terrible, Journal.
And it was.
But I didn't expect to smile or laugh.
To be surprised? To feel happy that people loved Gran, like I did. Each time I heard a story about Gran, I could imagine her laughing along with it. It was like she was there, with me, helping me through it. I still feel in pieces, Journal. Maybe there's a part of me that will always be sad, that will always miss her. But maybe that's okay. And that's the way it should be. I don't know what happens after we die, but I think I know where we go. Into all the people who have ever cared about us. We make a sort of place for them in our hearts. I need to finish Robin's story. Gran would want me to. I want me to. I think I know what to do now. Let's summarize. After the dragon attacked her village, the playful Robin set out to return the fireflies. On her travels, she met a grumpy djinn guarding a fallen city of warriors. And found a lonely fire creature named Lump. They became friends. But then, Lump needed to stay behind with the Ancient Ones in exchange for the gift of water breathing. Deep under the water, inside the Lost Seekin Palace, chased by the shadow of remorse, Robin had her big moment of doubt. But she pulled through it all. And now she is ready to face the dragon.
You. I thought I couldn't face you, but I couldn't face myself. I know you'll always be there. Maybe that's okay. You're part of this adventure. Part of me. Thank you. Now, I will return the fireflies. I'm coming for you, dragon.
with her confidence renewed, a newfound power coursed through her.
I feel like I can do anything. Light as a feather. Like cutting through the world welcomed her. Forward! She felt that she could touch the sky. A tall tower loomed overhead. Many moons had shone above since first it was built.
Another obstacle! Ha! After what I've been through, you really think that will stop me?
Robin's voice echoed over the age-old crumbling stones. A lone figure stood, unbowed, defiant. It drew her to it. Her foe rose before her. No breath in its body, but no less terrifying.
Nothing's moving. Must be more to do. That's it! A gust of fresh air rewarded Robin's efforts. As she rose up the stairs, Robin knew the tower's purpose: to watch over a long forgotten land should ancient evil stir. No statue this time, but bone and scale. Its fire-wreathed home, waiting.
There you are! And here I come! Maybe this wasn't such a good idea. It was a great idea!
The world darkened around Robin. She had reached the dragon's mountain. For the first time, Robin felt no fear. She knew she had all she needed. Before her, a molten sea stretched into the distance. It did not slow her down.
I laugh in the face of lava.
Suddenly, Robin no longer felt the heat. In its stead, a cold dread crept up her spine.
This looks like my village. But it can't be. It's a trick. It has to be.
An eerily familiar sight awaited her.
That's my house. How? Eldereva! No! Wait! Come back! Oh!
Only emptiness remained. Her thoughts raced ahead of her.
This can't be real. A trick. I can't let it be real.
She gripped the chain with furious determination. She gripped the chain with furious determination.
I know you're there! It won't stop me.
Oh. I hope you can forgive me.
Torn between rage
and regret. Robin pushed ever upwards. Even through adversity within and without, her determination shone bright. She had grown. I hope you find your peace. Almost there. Chilling winds shook her to the bone. Still she climbed. Glad we're on the same page. Every stride, pushing against, storm and snow. Defiant. Unwavering. One step after the other. That's Paul. That's where I last saw... Lump!
Hulman! How are you here? Not sure.
I'm so glad to see you. After I left you, I felt so confused. I didn't know if I'd done the right thing.
Lump, see how far you come. You've grown big. Lump did right thing.
Don't go!
Have to, Robin. But we'll always be there in the membrane.
I'll make sure to keep you there. Goodbye, little lump. Hello, dragon. Here I come. Finally. Robin readied herself for a confrontation. Right. This is it!
Hello? Bit of an anticlimax.
When she first set out, Robin wanted to return the sacred fireflies to their rightful home. But now she realized that, regardless of how her adventure ended, the journey had forever changed her. Standing there, she felt... reflective. Every choice, every hardship and every challenge had been leading to this. No moment was wasted. It was a life lived, and it was hers.
Come forth, dragon. Every twist and turn of my journey has led me to you.
Why did
you scare away all our sacred fireflies?
Why? They were in my way.
They're with me now, and I won't let you harm them.
You cannot win this battle. Begone!
Disappear.
I am the Unmaker, the Ender of Worlds.
Not this one.
All things must come to an end. Your friends, your family, you.
Not if I can help it.
In time, even dragons fade. Ponder this elsewhere.
Make a difference. I know that now.
You have been reading the wrong stories, little one. Sometimes things just end.
If you want to end this world, you're going to have to go through me.
Yes, that's what I've been trying to do.
Then it seems we are at an impasse. You can't hurt me, and I can't hurt you.
And what is your solution, little one?
I'm not sure. Maybe just talk it out?
Very well. You may ask me one question.
Make this one count, Robin. Where does their power come from?
At first, I thought they could be destroyed along with the rest of your world.
But they couldn't.
No. They are ancient energies. As am I. We are part of the same cycle.
So the Fireflies are the key to stopping you.
There is no stopping until I am done. Then I can rest. Then I can dream. Until it begins again. You have had your one question. I have work to do.
And I think it always will be.
I envy your fight.
It
can be yours too. You can change things. You can't hurt me!
I did not aim for you. Some things are not to be changed, not to be stopped. They must be accepted.
I can't accept this. What happened?
It's all gone, I'm afraid.
It can't be just gone. Why couldn't I do anything? Why couldn't I save it?
There was nothing to be done. Everything has a time to go. Even worlds.
But I don't want that. I feel like a failure.
That's silly. You didn't fail because you couldn't win. The dragon is part of the world cycle. It cannot be broken.
Then, what was the point of all of this? I failed before I even started.
You recovered the fireflies. Ancient energies born of the same cycle. Between you, them, and your book, you'll work it out.
Wait! What do you mean? Come back! Please come back.
There was only one place left to look.
Astoria was gone, but the fireflies still remained. Waiting for a new beginning. You're rebuilding the world, aren't you? And you're starting with my memories. a fruitful work. A remembrance of home. I've run out of fireflies. We're stuck. There's still something missing. Hey, you're still here, Firefly. Can you help? That's it, Firefly. Now you're ready for a new story. And I have to say goodbye too. Thank you, Firefly. You didn't make it. You knew, didn't you? That you wouldn't? That's why the Firefly came to me. They knew too. So, these are my memories of you. That's where you live now, isn't it? Within me. I'll hold you close. I'll take you with me. Let's see what adventures lie ahead.
Hello, journal. Reading these dusty pages makes me feel old. I reread them so many times as a kid, taking myself back to those dark moments, reassuring myself it would all be okay. That helped. You helped. I still miss Gran every day. Sometimes I hear her laugh in the back of my mind. Abby reminds me of her. Insatiably curious and fiercely independent. I hope she never loses that. Mum's coming to live with us for a bit. I hope her and Abby are going to make some memories of their own. They're already both obsessed with cat videos and InstaSnap. Abby's birthday is coming up. Maybe I'll get her a journal of her own. She says she wants to be a writer.